Hi there, Matt Carter here. I'm just going to do a quick video on seeds and how they work and what they are. It's basically a number that affects the random generation of the noise that the AI uses to create the image. It's very subtle. Sometimes, and sometimes it is far from subtle. So if we do something incoherent, right, let's just use this little house here, and I'll put in a prompt. A small country house with a garden path, trees surrounding, and clouds in the sky. Right, so we'll just put in number one. We'll leave everything else as it is and we'll hit create. Okay, so here we go. It's almost done now. It's gone on a little mission, it looks like. You can see it's there, I guess, but it looks kind of weird. However, that's it finished. So that's what it's come up with. Now let's just duplicate that. We'll leave it, but this time I'll tell it to use 5 seeds. Again, I'm not touching anything else. Are we incoherent? We are. Right, so I'm not touching anything else. It's now going to create it again, but using 5 different seeds this time. So let's see what it comes up with. Okay, so I've ran those 5 and I've got the original one in there, and there you go. They are actually quite different. I wonder if the reason for that may be that I used a hand-painted drawing and it's made, you know, some really stark differences. These two are kind of the same. Let's have a look. Let's just do a wee bit of investigation work. Seed 1 on that one. Seed 1. Interesting. Seed 423728. I wonder how it managed. Interesting that it used seed 1 again. It must have picked it up from the duplicate for one of the. Aye, that's what it's done. So what's that one? 423728. 36217. 927899. And 716199. So you can see. It's made quite a vast difference, actually. Now, what you can do is you can remember the seeds and use them in a specific, you know, if you like the aesthetic of that, you can use the seed in another picture and hopefully it will give you the same kind of result, you know, like that fluffy clouds and stuff. So let me just try that, see if it works. Probably won't. Because I'm making a video, but let's see. Right, so picture of trees, mountains, sun, and a lake. right, great picture. So we'll try changing it a wee bit. So a lake, some trees, mountains in the background, with the sun in the sky. Right, let me just duplicate this. Let's see what one's pretty distinct. That one's more distinct than the other ones, I think. What seed did it use? Right, let's see what happens. Let's see if we can get something coming up kind of similar to that. And we'll just leave everything as is again. Oh, it's coherent, yep. Right, see what happens. Okay, so that's the one I did. A lake, some trees with the seed of 716199. And that looks pretty similar to that. As in, you know, these bits, these brown bits. Kind of similar, so it's got the same kind of feel. But yeah, seeds are worth messing around with. Now, I don't know if there's a problem in staging at the moment, but I'll give you a little once over regarding what seeds are. So a seed is a number value which helps to instruct the AI where to start generating random pixels, which in turn create the image in the end. So that's what I was saying about the seed basically indicates to the AI where to start creating noise. So, and that's how this is done. You know, the AI starts with noise and then creates the image from that. VQ Gannon clip and clip guided diffusion seeds are not truly deterministic, but seeds in stable diffusion are, which is something you guys will get to experiment with soon in Night Cafe. So, what does that mean? I'll show you. So, if I take this, and are we in staging? No, this is staging. So let's do this. I'll go 16 images. Let's go widescreen. Right, and let's just leave it as is. So I think by deterministic, I think what they mean is you can create something. I think we might have a problem. Oh no, it's only coherent that's down at the moment in the staging. Staging's basically where we test everything first. So by deterministic, I think it means if you create something and you really like it, you can create it again using the same seed and you'll get exactly the same image. So let's have a look. So that's Stable's view of it. So if we look at these, so let's say we like that one. And if we come down here, 49476 3, and I'll just show you just to make sure we'll select that one and see if the seed changes. It does. So what we can now do is let's just duplicate this, but we'll use that seed and I'll just do one image. Let's see what happens. It should turn out. Oh, I can't remember what one I did now. What one was it? Wasn't that one? I think it was this one. 49476 3. Yeah, I think it was that one. So it should turn out the same as that. There you go. So whereas if I was to try that in artistic or coherent mode, that's not what would happen. So seeds are a random number that tell the AI where to start when creating the noise. They can make a massive difference or a little difference, and in stable diffusion, they are deterministic, which means if you've got the seed from any given creation and the prompt, you can create it and it will create exactly the same. So I kind of think that's that for this video. As per usual, if you've got any issues, pop them in the comments or get in touch with me through Discord. And by the way, if you guys go to join Night Cafe and are taking the pro subscription, if you look in the comments, I've got a code that you can use. It's Mac Hatter, or click on the link and you'll get 5% off, which is pretty good. I think that's it. Yep, no point showing you any more on seeds because it's really that simple. It's just a randomly generated number that can give you different aesthetics. But the great thing is you can keep the number and reuse it later on to get close to the aesthetics again. So thanks for watching the video. As always, give me a shout if you watch the videos and you come into the Discord, say hello. And I'll be happy to say hi. So thanks for watching. Take it easy. Bye bye.